Hello, my name is Jessie. I'm a pediatric nurse practitioner. Today, I want to talk to you about the coronavirus disease, also known as COVID-19. There is still a lot we don't know about this virus, but we are learning every day. When in doubt, go to trusted resources like CDC and WHO for the most updated information. All information presented in this video is up to date as of March 22, 2020. Knowing how the coronavirus spread is going to help you understand how to prevent it effectively. Right now, the consensus is that the main method of transmission is by respiratory droplets. Our droplets can travel very far, especially when you're coughing or sneezing. That's why maintaining a distance of 6 feet with others is very important. Depending on the situation, the coronavirus can live on surfaces for up to hours, even days. So please avoid touching common surface areas, especially in public places. Those places include, but not limited to, the elevator buttons, shopping carts, doorknobs, and light switches. Clean before touching if possible. Use your knuckles or elbows instead of your fingers or the palm of your hand whenever possible. And remember, clean your hands afterwards. Recent studies have suggested that the coronavirus aerosol particles could stay in the air for up to 3 hours. Don't go to crowded places, you say? You've got it. You have probably heard 1,000 times by now that washing your hands is important. Why? When you get viruses on your hands by respiratory droplets or from contaminated surfaces, as long as your skin is intact, they cannot invade your body. But they can enter it through your mucous membrane. That's when you touch your eyes, your nose, and your mouth. So don't touch your face. And wash your hands thoroughly for at least 20 seconds or 2 happy birthday songs. If hand washing is not convenient at the moment, use a hand sanitizer that contains at least 60% alcohol. If you have a fever or any other respiratory symptoms, stay home unless going out is absolutely necessary. And please wear a mask when you go out so that you can protect everyone else around you. So some people have been telling you that the coronavirus is just like the flu. Is it? Let's look at some data. In the flu season of 2017 to 2018, the CDC estimates 45 million people had the flu with 61,000 deaths. That's a very high number. As I'm making this video, there are 32,644 confirmed COVID-19 cases with 409 deaths. That seems like just a fraction of numbers of cases compared to an ordinary flu season, right? But let's look at the government and society's response and the impact around you. President Trump declared national emergency on March 13, 2020. The first time in the past 10 years for medical reasons. In an effort to contain the spread in the community, many local governments have established temporary closings of businesses that serve the public, like bars, restaurants, and gyms. And several states has ordered mandatory closing for all non-essential businesses. Many school districts in the nation are closed indefinitely. The stock market has been crashing. I don't think an ordinary flu season has ever had this much impact. Plus, there are no well-established vaccines or treatments for the coronavirus yet, unlike the flu. And the testing ability is very limited as of this moment, leading a lot of potentially undiscovered cases, unlike the flu. Simply put, the coronavirus is not just like the flu. My intention is not to provoke panic or fear, but to bring to light the information I think you should know so that you can make an informed decision about your actions and how they can potentially impact your community. I don't think you should panic or be scared, but I do think you should be alert and do everything in your power to try to make the outcome of fighting this novel virus a little better. Here's some good news. Generally speaking, 80% of the people with coronavirus have mild symptoms like cough and fever, or even no symptoms at all. Only 20% of the cases with more severe symptoms like shortness of breath will require hospitalization at the discretion by your doctors. So, if you're a young, healthy individual, your chance of recovering from this illness is very high. Does this mean you should stop caring about it and go about your life just as it is? No. This is also where a lot of danger exists. Because many people have mild to no symptoms, they don't get ill enough to stay put or quarantine themselves. That makes it so much easier to spread in the community. This disease is very contagious, more contagious than the flu, with an R-naught ratio between 2 to 3, meaning on average, every patient with coronavirus will infect the next 2 to 3 people. This might not sound much at first, but when the next 2 to 3 people infect 4 to 9 people, the next 4 to 9 people infect 8 to 27 people, the next 8 to 27 people infect 16 to 81 people, the next 16 to 81 people infect 32 to 243 people, then 64 to 729 people, then 128 to 2,187 people. The snowball effect is seriously alarming. And when the number of people getting sick increases quickly, the number of people with severe symptoms that require hospitalization also increases. 20%, remember? This will overwhelm your local hospital. We simply do not have enough hospital beds, ICU beds, and ventilators to keep up with the demand if our demand increases exponentially like Italy has. Then the death rate will increase significantly because not everyone who should be treated will get the treatment they need. You know how serious things are in Italy right now, right? Italy has 59,138 confirmed cases and 5,476 reported deaths so far, with a whopping death rate of 9% compared to the death rate of around 4% worldwide. On March 21st, Italy reported 793 deaths in just one day. When the healthcare system is overwhelmed, the death rate will increase. As shown in this graph, we have been following a very similar curve with Italy, but with a two-week delay. We don't want to follow their curve. We don't want to peak like they did. We want to flatten the curve and let our number rise slowly and then start to decrease. We need you on this one. We need you to buy us time. And time is one of the most important things we need to win this battle. You are buying time for scientists and doctors to develop new vaccines and treatments. You are buying us time to slow down the spread of this disease so that hospitals have enough resources like ICU beds and ventilators for people who truly need them. So now, can you feel how important you are in fighting this battle against the coronavirus? Many businesses have already been making sacrifices and contributions in order to protect public safety. Non-essential businesses closing or allowing their employees to work from home, some essential businesses like Walmart and Whole Foods opening extra hours for elderly to shop, protecting their health while ensuring they can get adequate supply. People in the service industry, like police officers, firefighters, grocers, and many others are not able to work from home. They are working so that your basic needs are fulfilled. Doctors, nurses, and many other healthcare workers are holding the fort down, working at the front line, facing the virus head-on despite of lack of testing and shortages of supply for personal protective equipment. Did you know many of them actually belongs to the at-risk population for severe illnesses? We go to work, put our lives and our family's life on the line for you. So please, stay home for us. If you and your families stay home as much as you can, don't go out to parties or large gatherings. Limit your unnecessary trips to crowded or potentially crowded destinations as much as you can. You can stop the disease from spreading to you and everybody else close to you. And you are saving lives. You matter. Your actions matter. By following the guidelines of the CDC and the WHO, and by washing hands properly and frequently, cleaning regularly, and practicing social distancing, you will limit your chance of obtaining and spreading this disease. These techniques have proven successful in countries that have contained the spread of the coronavirus. In this battle fighting against the coronavirus, there is a special group of people that needs our love and care. They are the at-risk population for severe illnesses, people who are above 65 years of age or who have chronic illnesses include but not limited to heart disease, lung disease, or diabetes. If they get this disease, the chances of them having more severe symptoms and worse outcome is much higher. Maybe they are one of your loved ones. Maybe you're also worried about them. And maybe, just maybe, you hope not only you, but everyone else can help to protect them. So, let's start from you. You matter. Your actions matter. If you are experiencing symptoms like fever and cough, call your doctors first. Follow their instruction. Do not show up unannounced. If you do have coronavirus, by showing up unannounced, you are going to put your doctors, nurses, and everyone else in danger because most offices don't have adequate personal protective equipment for the healthcare workers due to the shortage of supply. If you instead rush to the emergency room, with their high patient volume and high crowd concentration, you will have a much higher chance to get other people's germ and give them yours. Even if you do have coronavirus, with only mild symptoms like fever and cough, your doctor is most likely going to send you home for self-quarantine and self-recovery. Because as of this moment, there's no well-established treatments for the coronavirus, especially for the mild symptoms. And if you didn't have the coronavirus, one trip to the emergency room is likely going to get you exposed. So please call your doctor first. Yes, we are facing a pandemic worldwide. And yes, as much as we don't want to admit, in the United States and other countries across the globe, we are fighting a serious battle with the coronavirus right now. But the most important thing is you matter. Your actions matter. You are one of the most valuable assets that we can count on to stop this disease from spreading. So, are you in? And to all my fellow healthcare workers and people working in the service industry, thank you. Thank you for all your hard work and sacrifices. Please stay safe and stand strong. And to everyone who's watching this video, if you like the message I'm sending, please share it with the people you care about. Sleep well, stay hydrated, eat healthy, keep up with the best immune system, and take good care of you and your family. I look forward to the days that we can shake hands and share hugs again.